Steve Bannon. We're going to talk about him. I think he is a leader for we the people. We're going to also talk about the NFL and what's been going on since the American people have spoken. And also we're going to have a special guest, John Michael Chambers. Don't miss the show, people. Stay with me. Welcome to TalkAmericaRadio.us. I am your host, Suzanne Shattuck, with Wide Awake. Welcome to WJHC 107.5 FM, WDDQ 92.1 FM, and WLBB News Talk 1330 AM. Well, we're going to be talking about quite a few issues, but I have to, again, we're going to return to the NFL because I am just, and I think you were probably the same, just tickled. I am tickled that what's happening right now with the NFL. I believe I read somewhere in Southern California, the LA Rams, I believe they're down like 20,000 of their normal fans. It was an article, I believe, let's see, in the Kansas City Star. And it was talking about Roger Goodell, and I don't know if that's how you pronounce his name. He's the commissioner of the NFL. He wrote a letter to all 32 league owners about this kneeling protesting going on and said, look, everyone should stand for the national anthem. And if you, again, we talked about leadership on this show not too long ago. And it's like if these leaders of these teams and like from the top down would have from the very get-go when Kaepernick, you know, last year decided to kneel, should have been nipped in the bud right then and there. He should have been made an example of, should have been fired, let go, say, you know, go play in another sandbox because this is not the way our players are going to act. And it's like, you know, that all this could have been saved. All this, you know, all this controversy and division that's happened in our country, you know, didn't even have to occur if we had leaders that would stand up from the get-go and not waiting to see, you know, to lick their finger and see, you know, which way the wind's blowing before they make a decision. If they made it on principle, if they were men of character, and you make the decision on principle, not what everybody else is doing, not what the masses want, you make it on principle. And this wouldn't have been an issue. But I just think it's so interesting now. I believe also it might have been somebody was calling for, I guess, the NFL, you know, to reword the manual that, you know, everyone should stand for the national anthem. And I say, let's see how many of these NFL players say, you know what, I've got to kneel. This is I'm going to kneel on principle. Let's see how many of them that are making millions of dollars, how many of them are going to walk away from that job? I venture to say zero, because money talks all day long, and that's what's happening here. The American people, once again, have spoken. They are not showing up to these games. They are not supporting this type of disrespect for our country. And I am, like I said, I'm tickled because Trump, again, that is a true leader. No matter what you think of Trump, he made the decision, went right out from his gut, from the way he was raised. You know, this is not what we do. This is disrespectful to the country, and you should stand or you should be fired. And he was right. And again, did not back down. Did not back down. I am, like I said, more increasingly, sometimes I get frustrated with Trump. But I'm telling you, this issue, just like many in the past, he has come out on top. He will stick with it, stand by his word, and he'll come out on top. So I just want to point that out. I think it's just interesting to see. You know, I'd love to see some of these players be let go, like I say. But you know what? It's sad. It's kind of like we're harkening back to Rush's article. It's kind of sad to see what's happened, though, to the game, because I think they've lost so much respect, and I don't know if they'll be able to get it back. I really don't. And that's so sad, because I know growing up, I just loved, like, even the sound of a football game on Sunday. It was just relaxing. And I just love to hear the background noise of a football game. I did read, too, there was somewhere in Pennsylvania, I think it was Albright College, a 19-year-old freshman quarterback decided he was going to kneel for the anthem. And he's gone. Dismissed from the team. There is a leader right there, whoever that coach is. It's like, nope, we're not going to stand for this. Or we are going to stand for this. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, I know you guys are aware of that, but I wanted to touch on that. The other thing that is I'm so jazzed about is Steve Bannon. Steve Bannon was on Hannity the other night, and I want to play you a clip. I'm going to bring that up here in just a moment. But he's speaking about Senator Corker in Tennessee that just made – let me read you some of these tweets that Corker said about the president. He said, it's a shame the White House has become an adult daycare center. Someone obviously missed their shift this morning. I mean, and people talk about, you know, Trump's tweets. I mean, this man here, again, he's a Republican. Listen, just like, you know, the decloaking is happening out in the national security, the deep state, we're coming to find out what's been going on for decades. Some things are being brought to light. And that's going to be touched on in the next couple segments with my guest, John Michael Chambers. But just as that decloaking is happening, the establishment Republicans are being totally dressed down. We are seeing the absolute fakes that they are. They have been put into positions of power. They have been entrusted. We have entrusted them. We have voted for them to take care of business, and they have not done it. And I'm telling you what, Steve Bannon is on the warpath. I want you all to listen to this clip. I think it's a couple minutes long. So, and then we'll talk about it. And Hannity does a super job, too. He does a super job. So hold on just a moment. Let me get this up. But I want, and I'm going to discuss a little bit of it after I play the clip.
I'm going to be, I know a lot of people didn't like in 2010, for example. Delaware. Well, I thought Christine O'Donnell was a nice woman. But you're picking the rock-solid, credentialed candidates.
We're spending a ton of time with the grassroots organizations to make sure that these candidates are fully vetted. You're going to see people announced this week that are going to have experience in government. You're going to see some outsiders that are authentic, and these people are real. It's not like 2010. 2010 was the beginning of the Tea Party when things were first getting going. You're going to see real candidates, and by the way, they're going to take on incumbents in every state, and they're going to take on the Democrats after
You
that.
Said in the 60 Minutes interview, you're a street fighter. I'm a street fighter, too.
I noticed that.
Okay, you noticed that? I'm not supporting any Republican incumbent that hasn't gotten their job done. Not one, Steve. I refuse. They have betrayed the American people. They have betrayed their promises. How do you make a promise for 7.5 years and not fulfill it?
It's a lack of sense of urgency. By the way, these guys work 3 days a week. The American people, now people working two jobs, their wives are working two jobs. They know the urgency out there on the economic hate crimes that have been perpetuated on the American working men and women in this country because of the trade deals.
Is this a fair statement? Is Steve Bannon declaring war on the establishment that are not for the working men and women in this country?
100%. We are declaring war on the Republican establishment that does not back the agenda that Donald Trump ran on and the President of the United States. And that is an agenda that we know backs the working men and women.
This is basically a war because you know what McConnell did in Alabama. And you know there are people out there. Look at that.
I've had donors.
Carl Rove is going to put in all their money.
Carl Rove, Stephen Law, these guys should get the joke. Their donors are coming to us because they're tired of having their money burned up by trying to destroy people like Judge Moore. It's a new game in town. We're going to cut off the oxygen to Mitch McConnell. Mitch McConnell's biggest asset is the money. We're going to make it the biggest liability. We're going after these guys tooth and nail.
Now, what's not to love about that? I mean, listen, I'm going to tell you, ever since Trump was elected and after he went into the White House, remember how Trump was out drumming up? I mean, it was pep rallies everywhere he went, you know, thousands, you know, into the teens and maybe 20,000 showing up at his rallies. Then after he got inaugurated, it's like he went behind a wall. And then there was nobody left to lead the deplorables, to lead the American people who voted for that agenda And that's what it is. Some people, I know some people say, oh, peeps, there are these always Trumpers that never, and there are, there's some people out there to a fault. They're like, Trump can do no wrong. And look, he's human. He's disappointed me on some of the issues as far as the Islamic issue and immigration, refugee resettlement. But I think he'll get to it. But listen, the people voted not for Trump. They voted for his agenda. And they see what's happening in D.C., where these establishment Republicans are not backing what the American people voted for. And this is what I think is interesting. In Alabama, where Judge Moore won down there against Strange, and remember, McConnell dumped millions of dollars into the establishment Strange in that primary run down in Alabama. And Trump actually was behind Strange. Remember, he showed up and encouraged, you know, people to vote for Strange. Moore won. And that is because the American people support the agenda of Donald Trump. They support that agenda. There is so much power behind that agenda. And so I just want to point that out. And Steve Bannon understands that. He is out there to harness that power and to kick these establishment guys out. That's what I believe. And listen, they ought to be running scared. Did you hear what Bannon said? The donors of people like McConnell and the like are sick and tired of what they've been up to. They are now coming to Bannon, giving him money. I think this is an incredible time to be alive. And I'm telling you, you need to get in the game. We can no longer just sit and get on Facebook and just, you know, be preaching to the choir. We have got to make our votes count, kick these establishment people out. And then on top of that, you need to prepare yourself, you and your family, prepare to take care of yourself, because we are in uncharted waters. The decloaking, like I said, of the security, the deep state, the shadow government is happening like never before. And they are being, that monster, that swamp is being kicked in the face, and it is very angry. And we do not know what we've got going down the road with North Korea. You need to be prepared to take care of yourself and your family, because we don't know what the future holds. So two things: be involved in your local politics and in your state, kicking these establishment Republicans out, because they are obviously a wall. They're building a wall and trying to keep Trump in. When he wants to further the agenda that the American people voted for. And they are trying to, you know, impede him from doing so. I mean, Bannon was talking about Corker, McConnell, and the rest. They're like this globalist. They're in some globalist clique. And my next guest, very well read on globalism, the economy. He's all about freedom. I'm really excited about him. And in an ebook that you all will be able to get, you just have to listen to the link that he'll share. He's going to share about how to download that, and it's just common sense, and it's about us coming together. We have got to stick together, just like the NFL. You know, NFL, I think Goodall was saying, look, you know, this has divided our fans. It's divided our fans, meaning, you know, divided fans. Well, it's they're losing money, but look how the divisiveness. We have to bring people together. We have to do that. And I thought it was interesting also, Bannon was talking about, look, we're meeting with the grassroots, because I know we're all tired of putting our votes out for somebody who gets in office and then doesn't do anything you want them to do. And so I think Bannon has got it. He has got his ear, just like Trump, he's got the pulse of the people. And if you stick with that and with this agenda, that's what the American people want, and there is huge power behind it. So anyway, I wanted to touch on that. And just like I said, just very jazzed about Bannon and what he's got going on. I think he is going to just drum up all kinds of excitement about the 2018 elections and what is possible. And what is possible. So you all hang on through the break here, because like I said, we've got John Michael Chambers coming on, and you're going to like him. You're going to like him a lot, and I'm actually going to be speaking with him Very honored to be speaking with him on the same platform, him and Tom Trento with the United West down in Sarasota, Florida. I'm just going to be speaking on the refugee resettlement program, immigration in general, and what a silent conquest that is. We've got to really keep our eye on the ball on the immigration and Americans first, right? We need to keep Americans first, and then we can help others. You all stay on with me, and we will return in just a moment. Thanks so much.
Hey, Donna, let's talk about a new network that's out. You can watch this, ladies and gentlemen, on any of your phone devices, your iPads, your computers, smart TVs. It's available almost any place, and it's called CRTV. And what that stands for, ladies and gentlemen, is Conservative Review Television. Now, the hosts that are on there, Donna, who are some of the hosts that are on this? I want you to tell the people about them.
Just the very best talk show hosts you could imagine. Mark Levin, Michelle Malkin, Mark Stein, and Steven Crowder, just to name a few.
Here's the other thing about this, ladies and gentlemen. This is on demand. This television and this network works around your schedule. And all you do is you log in. And you watch. You can watch Mark Levin. You can watch Michelle Malkin. You can watch Crowder, Steven Crowder.
Mark Stein.
You can watch Mark Stein. Any of these great conservative hosts on demand, and they're ready to perform and educate you whenever you're ready, whenever you can fit it into your schedule. Now, go to crtv.com, hit the /cowboy. So it would be crtv.com/cowboy. Or you can put cowboy in the promo code. You're going to get a discount if you do this. So please, ladies and gentlemen, Donna and I are subscribers to this. We don't get it free because of being affiliated with CRTV. These are just good friends that really know how to educate the right way. It's not fake news.
Hi, this is Donna Fiducia, co-host of Cowboy Logic Radio. For 28 years, I was in the mainstream media, most recently as an anchor at the Fox News Channel. No more. Ladies and gentlemen, the mainstream media has completely failed the American people. Radio networks like Talk America Radio will not fail you. Radio shows like Cowboy Logic Radio will not fail you. Check out the entire roster of over 60 weekly radio shows by visiting talkamericaradio.us. That's talkamericaradio.us.
Talkamericaradio.us. Accuracy and range are a necessity. Now comfort is an option as well. Nemo Arms introduces the Omen 300 Win Mag. The Omen 300 is perfectly balanced for reduced recoil, creating sub-minute of angle accuracy. And fit with the tightest of tolerances, the Omen is offered in carbine or full-length models with a 10 or 14 round magazine. American made, owned, and designed, Nemo Arms is setting a new standard in modern sporting rifles. Find out more at NemoArms.com.
Friends, thanks for hanging on through the break, and I'm very excited to actually have someone on today that's going to speak with us. His name is John Michael Chambers, And I just started reading, I guess, some of his material and learning about him and what he's doing. And come to find out also that we were going to be speaking at the same event in Sarasota, Florida in a couple weeks. And when, so John, thanks so much for coming on the show with us today.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. And let me see if I get, there's a lot to talk about what you've done, but you're speaking across the country right now. You are an author. One of the books I believe that's on your speaking tour is Trump and the Resurrection of America. You're a financial advisor, a wealth coach, and you've been, you know, and you're a radio talk show host as well.
Well, yes, sort of. Just a couple of clarifications. I'm a recovering financial advisor. I retired from that about 10 years ago, actually, 2008, and did some consulting. But my work, predominantly, I'm promoting the book and doing a speaking tour around the country to try and keep our movement together and keep people informed. And I'm acting as a wealth coach. I have a wealth coach consulting business as well, but not really financial advice. I don't sell investments, insurance, or manage money anymore.
Okay. But you're definitely, I think what I'm understanding as I'm reading about you and your philosophy, I guess, is the fact that you promote freedom throughout, whether it be finances, economy, and religious freedom. And I'm really, I started reading your, I don't know if it's a book or just a paper, How to Detect Truth from Lies in the Age of Fake News. And I want to talk about that this morning, because that is an amazing, what you've written. You've really simplified. And I liked at the beginning how you said you like to make things simple. And in our complex world, especially when our attention span is that of a gnat, you really do have to get fairly simple with all of us, because we've got so much going on, in our life. So you can tell us a little bit about that. Talk a little bit about, I guess it's what was in that book also. It's new opportunities through the paradigm shift of consciousness. Can you kind of explain the paradigm shift to my listeners?
Sure. Thanks. This is actually a free digital ebook that I put together maybe about 2 weeks ago. I'm making available to anybody interested, and it's how to detect tell truth from lies in the age of fake news. The paradigm shift is really, I believe that, and this has been going on for some years, gradiently and sort of gradually increasing. This is my opinion. Is there's a great awakening taking place, really within the human spirit. For all of us across the globe, and those that can feel it and hear it, in ways known or unbeknownst to them, to us, we're acting on this because we're able to see things a little more clearly now. And this is also, in my opinion, how and why we have a President Donald Trump in office. Mm-hmm. And so it's a great opportunity. I have a simple formula. I call it time plus Trump equals a more informed, engaged, and active electorate or populace.
Right,
because,
right.
Yeah, I spent a lot of time out of the country in the past 5 years, and it's been my observation that time plus Trump has worked out well in terms of the enlightenment, people being able to see things. And I think as people, and what my mission is in part, is to find the entry point of what most people understand and take it a few more levels deeper, so they really understand how long this game's been run on us, and that this is for all the marbles, so to speak.
Right.
So people need to get some skin in the game.
Can you tell me, if you can, what countries were you traveling in?
Sure. Mostly Asian countries, but I did have spent 2 months in Belize, where I was writing a different book some years back. But I was in Thailand, China, mainland China, Tibet, Laos, Myanmar, Philippines, Hong Kong, and Belize. I think that covers most of it over the last 5 years.
Yeah. And I hear you when you're talking about Trump and plus time, you know, it does. I think after I was a little disappointed, I'd say after the election, where I felt like, you know, so much of us were energized and just had all this momentum going. And I don't know if you used to see some of the memes, you know, with like this big, the Trump train, you know, this big locomotive, and how we had so much steam. And I just feel like once he got into office, you know, he had to start working. And it just didn't seem like there was anybody around to kind of keep that movement going. There wasn't any national leadership to kind of keep that going. And that I was, you know, I thought, wow, we kind of lost the momentum a little bit. But every time he seems to go out and do these rallies, it's just incredible, you know, the numbers that show up and how he gets. It's like a pep rally, you know. I mean, he's such a very good leader. In that respect of, you know, I guess he has the pulse of the American people, the true patriot, I think, of the American people.
I agree. And we haven't had, in my opinion, true leadership to restore or resurrect America from the depths of where it is in a very, very long time. And Trump is a natural born leader. Look, you're right, though, about when he has the rallies, the speeches today, he's still packing arenas like a rock star. But so, you know, the support is there. But in terms of like political active groups and such, whether they're Republican clubs or Tea Parties or Patriot groups, attendance has been down. I see that in many states I go to. And you know, because we're resting on our laurels, because Trump is now in office, or also because people are tired from all the work they did to get him in office. But this is really, the battle has just begun. People need to become very active, because the shadow government and the deep state are throwing everything they have at President Trump. They're not going to let up.
Right. And I mean, he is something like we've never seen, or I can't think of anybody like him. That will stand up and really not apologize. That's what I happen to love. My listeners have heard me talk about this before, but to me, a true leader is going to get up and say, you know, what they believe, and they're not going to go back on it because of what the pop culture is saying or what the, you know, what the mainstream media says. And that's what energizes me to also be bold and to speak out. But I think you're right as far as, you know, you look out there, and I'm sure you see it too, is, you know, just the apathy of some people that I guess just aren't engaged, or they are tired. And I understand them being tired, because a lot of times it's just a few people doing the work, just like at a church. You know, they say what, like 10% are the people in the church that are, you know, volunteering and helping in the nursery and doing all those kinds of things. But it's got to be the toughest job to be able to influence people to actually act, would you say?
Yes, it is. It is difficult. And one of the other reasons, at least in the political arena, that it's difficult is because most people are not leaders. Most people are followers. And there's nothing wrong with being a follower, as long as, you know, you do the homework of the ones you're following. But people need marching orders. That's the problem. People don't have enough tasks, if you will, of what can, you know, the average person's thinking, what can I do is the key word.
Exactly.
What can I do? And I'm actually going to be compiling a list from a lot of different minds and people that I know around me that have some great, great strategies, some great ideas, some great things people can do. You know, and I touch on some of that in the book. The book is really, it's an analysis of the state of affairs that we're in, but it also provides some ideas of things that people can do to assist.
Right. Well, I tell you, when I got really, really excited is when I read about your emergency preparedness. You talked about those four stages of denial, like it won't happen, or if it does happen, it's not gonna, it won't, you know, won't be me, and that kind of thing. Because I'm starting up some emergency preparedness classes with a good friend of mine, who kind of the same thing we've been talking about, how, and I think you even, there's a quote in your book about, you know, doing the same thing over and over and over and expecting a different result. It's like, you know, we've done so much educating of the public of what's going on, but what are we doing to maybe steer our culture and our people back to self-reliance and a rugged individualism, and, you know, and actually individualism itself, instead of what I get, and I don't know if you get this too, from the national media or from those movements on the left, that's all about the collective. You know, it's kind of like a Marxist type or a communist type thing where let's do this all for the good of the, you know, the good of the whole, instead of standing up and being an individual.
Yeah, absolutely. That's probably the foundation of the entire movement that's really thrown America upside down over the last couple of decades. And the legendary author and film producer, G. Edward Griffin, is a great place for your listeners to go visit in terms of the subject of collectivism versus individualism. Uh-huh. I had the opportunity to work with him some years ago when I had formed the not-for-profit Save America Foundation. And he did a speech on the Federal Reserve, of course, but he also did a speech on collectivism, and there's a lot of content available online for people, but he's really looked closely at that, and you're exactly right. That's the problem. We've gotten away from individualism and moved towards collectivism, which really is communism.
Right, so, and that's so much in our schools. I have four children and a senior left in high school, but she even comes home and can recognize this type thing. And how they, you know, try to put them in these boxes. You know, they try to divide them up into different groups, you know, and that's another thing, again, that you talked about in your book, was about, you know, divisiveness or divide and conquer, you know, which is what is happening right now. And I think what your movement is doing, your organization, is probably trying to bring people together, because you said, like you had said something about being a political atheist. And I love that, because, you know, sometimes even saying I'm a conservative can turn people off. They might not know anything of what you believe, but just that label has gotten a dirty name. And so I like the fact of, you sound like you know, you're an individual. You're going to take what you want, and you're not necessarily a Republican or a Democrat, but you're definitely standing for freedom in general. And I think that can bring so many Americans together. Just by talking about, you know, what are our commonalities?
Yep, absolutely. Political atheist has gotten, I'm glad you understood my play with words there. A lot of people haven't, and when I get the book reprinted, I'm just going to probably explain those two words in that paragraph, because some people said, oh, he's an atheist. No. I'm a political atheist. It's a play on words. I'm not, both parties have let us down. I follow the truth, you see. And this is where Trump's emergence on the scene is a great example, because, and people can see now, people can clearly see, this is why I'm talking about the awakening, like truth being revealed, lies are being exposed. These are defining times. And you know, with Trump in office, we're able to see a lot of things. And,
right.
Yeah.
He's definitely, the masks, I think, have been revealed more than any other time, just because I think he's calling a spade a spade. And he's, you know, a lot of people are seeing behind those masks.
But this talk in intelligence communities, I can name a few people specifically, they're being very vocal about it online, but... and there's lots of sources, but President Trump has alluded to and may very well be opening up the JFK documents to us and telling us what happened. President Trump may also be opening up the 9/11 investigation. These are very, I don't need to tell you what happens when those things become public information.
Exactly.
The tide changes very, very quickly.
Right. Real quick, before we go to a break, give us how people can follow you and get in touch with you and follow your work, and then we'll take a break.
Well, thank you. My book is available on Amazon.com, Barnes & Noble, and Apple in pretty much every format. And my website is CourseCorrectionsConsulting.com and JohnMichaelChambers.com. That's a blog website.
Super. Great. Well, I'm excited. You can stay on for one more segment, right?
Sure. No problem.
Great. Okay. So, people, we will be back with John Michael Chambers. He's got incredible books out there, incredible author and speaker. I will definitely put his stuff on my website so y'all can follow him. But stay with us through the break, and he will join us back, and we're going to be continuing to talk about Trump, about true leadership and the direction of this country.
This is Don Newen, co-host of the Drive Time Sit Rep. Join me as I call in to my intel analyst, Denise Simon, for my daily situation report, or Sit Rep, the Drive Time Sit Rep. Check talkamericaradio.us for more information and showtimes.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is AJ Gaynor, host of Blow and Smoke. Who is AJ Gaynor? Well, he's formerly the drummer for national recording artist 12 Stones, who you've probably never heard of, but why does he have a show? Well, he's widely read, widely traveled, and he enjoys the search for new perspectives. Why should you listen? First, because this is not your father's talk show. Second, because the idea here is each week I sit down with you for about an hour, and we discuss some current events, usually the political ones, but not always, and we try and identify what's real, and of course, what's the propaganda. We know the mainstream media has a narrative they're pushing, and on Blow and Smoke, we challenge that narrative, sometimes with simple facts, other times with instinctive logic, but always with truthful, honest debate. I've always said that my show is about finding perspective. I believe the perspective I provide my listeners is indeed unique. Tune in to Blow and Smoke with yours truly, AJ Gaynor, right here on the Talk America Radio Network and at talkamericaradio.us.
Hi, this is Donna Fiducia.
And Don Newen from Cowboy Logic Radio. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't go to sleep every night completely fatigued from trying to restore America from the destruction that is taking place,
then you're simply not doing enough. Join us every Tuesday night, 9 p.m. Eastern, for Cowboy Logic Radio.
Let the restoration begin.
Donald Trump came to Washington vowing to drain the swamp and make government work for the American people. But the swamp creatures in D.C. aren't going down without a fight, and the deep state is determined to overturn the election and keep their gravy train rolling. In these turbulent times, it's critical for patriots to stay engaged and be prepared to defend this president. You can stay up to date on Trump's battle to make America great again by listening to America First Radio with Jim Dawes each weeknight at 10 p.m. Eastern on the Liberty Feed.
Hi, I'm Michelle Malkin for Conservative Review. If you are sick of the clown show, freak show, scream fests on cable TV, you have to subscribe to Mark Levin's new TV show at LevinTV.com.
Friends, thanks so much for staying on with me to this third segment. We are with John Michael Chambers, and we're going to continue to discuss some of what is in the books that he's written, and that is, I think, uncovering the media, the deception in the media, all other arenas, too, in our culture. But the media specifically, John, is what gets me so irritated at the propaganda, you know, what the media has turned into. So what are you thinking about with the mainstream media, and how does Fox, you know, are we supposed to trust Fox or what?
Faux news, F-A-U-X. You know, that's a great subject. And again, Donald Trump, the candidate, brought that to the front of the stage 2 years ago, and it's increased. I mean, fake news is a branded term now that'll be around for a long time. But I go back to Michael Savage. This is the one of the first people that was blacklisted and removed, at least in recent history, from mainstream media because he tells it like it is. Of course, he's a hugely successful author and a hugely successful talk show host. But he calls it the government media complex, and indeed it is. Because the media, the mainstream media, you know, by and large, is the mouthpiece and controlled by the ruling elite and the shadow government and the structures that they have set up. So as far as Fox News go, this is just my opinion about Fox News. And I, you know, I started watching it, you know, a long time ago, maybe around 2000, you know, 17 years ago. And I said, oh, wow, this is refreshing. Look at this guy, Bill O'Reilly, and, you know, and Kennedy and Combs. I said, oh, fair and balanced. Makes sense. You know, but then, you know, wake up a little bit more. And long story short, especially today, we can see, in my opinion, Fox News was created as part of the standard ploy because there was too much to the left. And they have to, those that control the narrative for the American people have to have the opposing side to put all those talking points there to keep everybody engaged in their narrative so that they can go ahead and deconstruct the Constitution and the Bill of Rights, which they've been very successful at. So Fox News has worked. And now I believe there's this implosion, if you will, at Fox by design, all the scandals that are happening because they're decloaking. They're decloaking.
Right.
You know, that's what's happening. So, you know, certainly most conservatives understand CNN and ABC.
MSNBC.
Yeah, NBC. You know, how far left and how lunatics they're portraying themselves as. But Trump has exposed it again. Fake news is pretty obvious. Snopes in and of itself is a relatively fake source of content as well. It's all controlled by the same entity.
I was going to say, that's interesting that you're even saying, because Fox News was almost like to pacify the conservatives, you know, because, hey, look, they get to looking at everything as so leftist, they're going to go out and make their own, you know, and heaven forbid they do that, because then they'll be in charge of that news. We've got to set up a, you know, I don't know if it's a facade that, you know, that we are conservative news, but really not. I mean, really, it's kind of subtle in the way they don't, you know, they're a little deceptive in the way they report.
Absolutely. And the narrative that the framework that they give their hosts, talk show hosts, to work within creates a divisive American public. And that's the purpose.
Right.
They're still winning. They're still dividing and conquering.
Yeah.
And that's why I love Trump. He changes the narrative with one tweet, you know.
Exactly. I have to say, though, I do like Tucker. I think Tucker Carlson does a great job. And Hannity, too. I mean, Hannity's really stuck in there. And I think he, you know, in his heart, I think he loves this country. Anyway, I just want to put plugs in. Those are the two that I kind of enjoy on there.
Absolutely. And we've got, you know, still contracted with Fox, the great Judge Andrew Napolitano.
Oh, absolutely.
There's some good people there.
Lou Dobbs.
Lou Dobbs is good. I agree with that. But overall, we know what they're doing. And David Brock from Media Matters, funded in part by Soros, released a confidential report to his people, which I got a copy of in February of this year. Eventually, Hannity started bringing it to his talking points, and it's a blueprint laying out how they're going to delegitimize Trump, delegitimize the deplorables in the movement, and remove him from office and see he never gets reelected. And that's what we're seeing happening. And also remove the right wing, if you will, voice, which is why O'Reilly was booted out, and nothing to do with the sex thing. They always use sex as a way to do it, and that's just a discussion. It's an interesting paradigm shift, because thank goodness for shows like yours and others, and you know, the freedoms that we have on the internet, which is slipping away, are a great opportunity for us to spread the truth. And if people are always wondering, well, what can I do? Well, there's two simple things that anyone can do. Even, you know, there's a long list of things and more complex things, but one, spread the truth, expose the lies, and stay away from the rhetoric, and stop regurgitating spoon-fed talking points by fake news. People have to find alternative sources, and I listed a lot of them in that free digital ebook on how to detect truth and lies. You know,
that is exactly, I was just writing that down because I want to mention that to my listeners. They've got to get a hold. That's a super list that you put out on what are the trusted news sites that you can go to, you know, alternative.
Yeah. You know, people ask me when I'm speaking, you know, where do we go? And a lot of people know, and in fact, some of the sources I got were introduced to me by some good patriots around the country. But it is important to replace fake news with news that we gravitate to that's, you know, credible. And but the guts of that digital ebook is about which we don't have time to get into, so perhaps people can request a copy and we'll just send it to them. But or I speak of the Hegelian dialectic, which is basically the controlled thought, and it's all spelled out in there with some really good links, live links that take people to some videos that illustrate it and explain it. And it ties into false flags, and you know, if Las Vegas is another false flag. Kevin Shipp, I think his name is.
Yes, former CIA.
Yeah, there's something people need to see on YouTube. Just Google his name and put in shadow government, deep state, and you'll see a 90-minute PowerPoint presentation, which of course sounds really boring, but anybody who really wants the most detailed description of who they are, how they're structured, and what they're doing, that's the best source I've seen. I just watched it last night and shared it in my database.
Okay.
It's really powerful.
I believe he wrote Company of Shadows, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know if that's
correct.
Yeah.
That's correct. But it's very important because I've done a lot of research on this for almost a quarter of a century, and he's laid it out really, really well in 90 minutes for people to grasp the gravity of this situation. And I wrote a blog on my blog site, johnmichaelchambers.com, a couple of weeks back called It's Either Us or Them. And I believe that's the stage we're at. They can't hide. We know who they are. We know where they are. We know how they're structured. And so it's us or them. That's why it's, like I say, this is for all the marbles. We cannot lose this battle. God willing, Trump can stay in office for the next 7 years.
Right. And this may be one of your quotes. And if you stand idly by, you are an accomplice to what's happening, basically. So, you know,
correct.
It's like you can't just be on the sidelines. I mean, we've all got to be, you know, playing this game right now, because they're all on the field advancing, and we need to show up.
And they've had a head start because, you know, we were just happy Americans, you know, working, sending kids to school, doing our thing. And they've been undermining us and controlling it for a long time. So we're stepping up to the plate a little underfunded and a little unprepared and a little undermanned.
Right.
But that is changing. And the quote I've been saying for many years is, when your children and grandchildren ask you, what were you doing when the global governance was being introduced to America and the world, what will your answer be? Freedom, it's up to us. And that's really how I look at it.
Right. Absolutely.
So I'm just one person doing the best I can, you know, and that's all we can do, one person at a time.
Absolutely. And you're doing a tremendous job. And like I said, I'm so glad that I started looking more into your information and into your work, because then that does, you go, oh my goodness, there's somebody that I identify with them so much, what their thoughts are. And again, we need that unity, because that just makes it always makes me a little more bold when you know there's other people out there that are on the same sheet of music. And I just want to touch, we've got about four more minutes left, but I wanted to touch on something that my friend and I that are starting this preparedness class, we talk about the vulnerabilities of systems and specifically the technology of what, you know, and I love one of the quotes you put in that book is, have more smartphones increase the number of dumb people. And it's like, that's so true. And I just want you to comment a little bit on the technology that's out there and how we can become, is there anything where we could become more connected without our smartphones?
Well, you know, technology is a double-edged sword because, you know, it's a great way for us to be connected. We can get so much information. I mean, it's changed the world. But we, of course, know the censorship and the control with Google, the government, and Microsoft, and Zuckerberg. But you know, two-part answer to your question. One, fortunately or unfortunately, be that as it may, social media is very, very powerful for us to spread the news because, you know, no one believes fake news anymore anyway. So it's just a great tool. As far as not using the internet, you know, as a main approach, it's the ballot box. It's right there in your community. We've got to get these rhinos out of office. We've got to get the support that our president needs, because the Republicans are just as guilty as the Democrats at this point. Not all of them, but we know who they are.
Oh,
and Julian Assange also printed the report of which Republicans received what six and seven digit dollars from the Clintons during the campaign to run against Trump.
Sure.
So people can vote. People can get involved in their local elections in their community. You know, people can write blog. Well, back to the internet, write blogs. But
right.
You know, there's a lot of different things we can do. But There's some polling technology that I introduce in the book as well that has been introduced to President Trump before he was elected, 2 weeks before. And this is a some technology that can really transform things and also be used by the Trump administration as another direct voice and direct communication line to the American public, bypassing the normal information cartel structure.
Right.
And we're hoping to get this to President Trump a little bit later this year, and we're going to be reaching out to Steve Bannon for his help.
Oh, super. And he's the one I kind of look to, hopefully, for some national leadership, you know, to take people like us that are just raring to go. We just need, you know, we just need a leader to tell us where to go and what to do. On another note, you were talking about, you know, getting the rhinos out. And I thought, wow, what a sweet election down in Alabama that put Moore I guess, to at least won the primary. And I thought that was just, that's got to be, hopefully will create a ripple effect and also scare some rhinos out there.
I think it has, and I think it will. I met the judge many years ago when the Tea Party movement first started at a big conference, first big one of its kind in Nashville. Sarah Palin was there, Tom Tancredo, and the late, great Andrew Breitbart himself. I had a chance to shake his hand. But,
yeah.
I met Judge Roy Moore there and got a signed copy of his book, and we were going to bring him in as a speaker, but the schedules didn't work out. But yeah, that's a big move, and that's a big sign to get these rhinos running.
Sure, absolutely. Let's go ahead and go over again how people can contact you, how they can follow you, and a couple names of your books.
Sure. CourseCorrectionsConsulting.com is kind of the overall platform, which speaks to all the different things I'm doing. The books can also be linked up from there. Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and Apple. I have a blog site. I've written over 300 blogs in the less than 2 years, and that's johnmichaelchambers.com, and there's a lot of good content there. And if anyone would like a free copy of the digital book, How to Detect Truth from Lies in the Age of Fake News, they can just send us an email at info@coursecorrectionsconsulting.com. I wish I would have chosen smaller domain names and smaller email addresses, but that's what I've got.
No, that's super. And I'll share that on Facebook. And obviously people can follow you on Facebook as well, correct?
Yeah, it's John Michael Chambers. That's the Facebook name. And it's a business profile page, and I'm on there daily. It's a great, great way for us to connect up.
Great. Okay, John, thank you again so much. And hope to meet you in a few weeks in Sarasota. People can go to americastruths.com to look up that that event, and it's called Truth or Consequences. So anyway, thanks again, John, and you have a great day.
Thank you very much. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye. Thanks, folks. We'll talk to you next week.